A. Study of bacteria present in root nodules of leguminous plants. Plant materials. Rooted plants of fenugreek, peanuts, beans, etc. Apparatus. Glass slide, cover slip, watch glass, dropper, razor blade, and a compound microscope. Chemicals. Saffronin. 3 to 5% hydrogen peroxide solution. 70% ethyl alcohol. Introduction. Students, this practical is about bacteria present in root nodules of leguminous plants. Leguminous plants means plants having legume type of fruits like all pulses, fenugreek, peanuts, beans, etc. So, before you proceed with the practical, you must know a little about these bacteria. The bacteria inside root nodules of leguminous plants are rhizobium. These are called nitrogen-fixing bacteria. Rhizobium is usually found in soil, which is referred to as free living state. If these bacteria come in contact with roots of plants like fenugreek, peanuts, or beans, they enter the roots. Inside the roots, these bacteria multiply to form nodules. Now, what is the use of these root nodules to the plant? The rhizobium bacteria has the ability to convert nitrogen gas from air into compounds of nitrogen, like nitrates and nitrites. This process is called nitrogen fixation. Plants need a lot of nitrogen for their growth, but they cannot absorb this gas directly from air like oxygen and carbon dioxide. So, rhizobium bacteria provides them nitrogen. If nitrates and nitrites prepared by bacteria are excess, then the extra part which is not needed by the plant is released in the soil. And do you know, students, soil fertility is directly dependent on percentage of nitrogen in it. Thus, the soil becomes more fertile. But remember that rhizobium can do nitrogen fixation only when it is inside the roots of leguminous plants. Now, let us proceed further and see how to prepare a slide of rhizobium bacteria. Procedure. First, take a rooted plant of fenugreek or peanuts or beans that has nodules on it. Clean the roots with water and then sterilize them with 3 to 5% hydrogen peroxide solution. Remember, sterilization is necessary to remove the other types of bacteria present on the root surface which come from soil. 2. Dip the roots in 70% ethyl alcohol to sterilize the root surface for 4 to 5 minutes and then wash the roots with sterilized water. Now, cut the root nodules into thin slices with the help of a new razor blade. These are called sections. Transfer these sections in a watch glass in water. Take care that the sections do not dry up. Select a good section and keep it in dilute saffronin for 2 to 3 minutes. Keep the section on the slide and place the cover slip on it. Observe the slide first under low magnification and then under high magnification of the compound microscope. Observation. The bacteria present in root nodule are rhizobium. They appear pink in slide as they are stained with saffronin. These bacteria are rod-like, that is, bacilli. These bacteria are able to move in soil and hence can enter the roots of leguminous plants from the soil. Inference. Rhizobium is found in soil. These bacteria enter the roots of leguminous plants. Inside the roots, they multiply and form root nodules. Rhizobium can do nitrogen fixation only when it is inside the roots. This relationship of rhizobium and leguminous plant is called symbiosis, where both of them depend on each other. The nitrogen provided by bacteria increases the protein content from the plants. So, after performing this practical, students, do you think that rhizobium will help our farmers in any way? Yes. Rhizobium can be added to soil when leguminous crops or pulses are cultivated. This increases the protein percentage from the plant, crop production, and the soil fertility. Will rhizobium be useful when the crop cultivated is other than pulses? Rhizobium is the correct choice when the crop is leguminous. But For other crops, there are other nitrogen-fixing bacteria like Azotobacter, Azospirillium, etc.